won the toss and he's chosen to serve. And as he comes back, facing the royal box, tremendous cheer for the 26-year-old New Zealander. And an equally big cheer for the 1981 Wimbledon champion.
And so, Lewis to serve, first set, play.
Off we go.
Love.
Out called. Rather late call.
Well, really, John McEnroe astonished by that call, though he wasn't perfectly placed to see where the ball bounced. But we had a pretty good look at it from here, and I must say it looked desperately close to that line to me. I thought it could have well have been in. And the call was rather late. Here it bounces. Chris Lewis chasing it back well. I think in all these inconclusive replays, the only thing to say is that the best man to see sits on the line.
Well, it was a late call, and one hopes that the officials aren't a little too tense.
Love.
Acrobatics already from Lewis. Shades of the current semi-final.
Thank you.
Well, I think that fierce volley, the reflex volley, has caused him to break a string in his racket. That won't worry him at all. He'll have plenty there to strung to the same tension.
First game.
So a very healthy start for the unseeded player there, winning the service to 15.
Love one, McEnroe.
love.
Well, that shows the confident vein of Lewis there, trying to out-volley the serving volleyer.
Thank you. 30, love.
Fast play by McEnroe, but his opponent had a chance for a backhand volley winner there in that quick exchange.
Game, McEnroe. One game all, first set.
So the opening game, 1-15 by Lewis. And McEnroe replies with a love game. Foot fault called.
But he had a few of those in his semi-final. It disturbed him not a bit then. I hope it won't now.
Love 15. Love 30. Love 40.
Not wrong with that forehand lob.
McEnroe leads by 2-1, first set.
2-1, first set. Well, they both
15, love.
Thought they heard a let, and we've come to the conclusion that the click of the cameras at courtside, which you may be able to hear on our effects microphones, is responsible for the players thinking that the ball hits the net. Dozens of photographers, and they line each side of the court between the service line area.
Love.
And the care and the determination with which McEnroe played that forehand winner was something rather more than you expect from him. Shows how really keyed up he is, I think. Peter Fleming, the doubles partner of McEnroe, watching keenly.
Love. Gay McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 3-1, first set.
And now it's time for Lewis to stop the rot. He's lost 12 successive points.
Love. Thirty, love. Love.
And that's the sort of forehand under pressure that we've seen McEnroe make during this championship time and time again. Well served.
McEnroe leads by 3-2, first set.
But 3-2 with the break.
Oh!
Love 15.
And that's the first point against the service for Lewis.
All.
Throughout this championship, Lewis has found himself one of the best defenders under pressure on grass.
All.
Okay.
40-30.
The volley, a rather fast, well-timed volley, sped away, a little too fast for the agile Lewis.
McEnroe leads by 4-2, first set.
And McEnroe giving his opponent no chance there with an easy second service. That was as good as most people's firsts. 2-4 then, first set.
Love 15.
Out.
15-all.
Not much wrong with the Lewis volley. It was very deep, but McEnroe passed master at the art of counter-attacking with half volleys. Did it quite beautifully then. So two break points for a 5-2 lead. And that volley right out of the middle of the racket. So a magnificent pullback from 15-40 to Deuce. And this man getting all the acclaim at the moment.
Advantage McEnroe.
A quiet forehand pass, but perfectly disguised. Break point for the third time.
Game McEnroe. Change the balls, please.
First change of balls as McEnroe serves for the first set, leading 5-2.
Love. 30, love. Love.
Three set points, and McEnroe making great use of the new balls.
Game in first set, McEnroe. First set to McEnroe, 6-2.
In the first set, 27 minutes. Well, now, Lewis has had a taste of the left-hander's all-round play.
Lewis to serve.
Net.
First service. Love.
And that, I think, was the best first volley behind the service that Lewis has made. Really punched it away and it really flew across the court.
Well played indeed. And marvellous reflexes from Lewis. This is how he's so discomfited Curran, because he's there, poised at the net, can't guess which way McEnroe's going, but he's so quick. Very firm wrist, McEnroe unable to reach it in time. 30 love.
love.
And his first ace.
Second service.
That was very close. That was very close to being a double fault.
Game, Lewis. First game, second set. First set, McEnroe.
Well, Mark Cox sitting here with John Merritt and myself. Mark, he seemed somehow to be a little freer then, hit the ball more firmly.
Love one, second set.
love.
Now that really was a great chance for Lewis to make a pass there. Had lots of time.
love. love.
Well, he had a chance again there, but overemphasizing the top spin against the volley and completely mistimed the ball.
Oh!
Yes.
'40-15.
A confidence giving running pass that. Moving quite fast when he played that cross court return, Lewis.
Game McEnroe, one game all, second set.
He won his first service game of this second set to Love. Can he do it again?
Dean Love.
All. And McEnroe, how quick to recover from slipping there and staying quite cool when he was off balance and eventually winning the point. And if it's possible, that shows again increasing confidence on the part of McEnroe, taking the initiative away from the serving volleyer, coming in and making his volley pass. Really a great play that. And suddenly a heavier service from Lewis. Perfectly timed and really perhaps throwing the ball a little more forward than he has been doing so that he could lean onto it more.
Advantage, Lewis.
Just out.
Jane Lewis. Lewis leads by 2-1. Second set. First set, McEnroe.
McEnroe, 1-2.
Fifteen, love. Thirty, love. Forty, love.
Directional control of the McEnroe service is really quite something to do. As it was, in fact, against Lendl.
40,
yes.
Correction. First service.
Well, there's been a correction by umpire Malcolm Huntington. There it was. Well, never very conclusive.
Corrected call, ladies and gentlemen. First service.
Never very conclusive looking at those replays, but I'm glad the players agree with Malcolm Huntington.
Lewis scuttling across in anticipation of the cross-court backhand volley. Not an easy one for McEnroe to hit, and he bounced it too low. And there was the gap.
Game, McEnroe. Two games all, second set.
Once again, McEnroe's second service received just on the inside of the centre service line. And I'm quite sure Lewis wasn't quite prepared for that accuracy on the second service. Two games all, second set, first set, McEnroe, 6-2.
Love.
Now, if he can keep getting in as quickly as that, as he did then behind the service, he's going to have easier chances on the volley, I think.
Fifteen all.
Now, the returns of McEnroe have been so good that more or less, except here and there, they've caught the server down at his feet, and his half volleying and his low volleying hasn't been penetrative enough. He really has got to get in much quicker or hold back a bit and get a proper ground stroke.
That's a wonderful return.
And this is what I meant about McEnroe seeing the ball so much earlier than anyone else. It was a fast serve, that, and yet he had time to move forward into the ball, all the weight behind it, a blocked wrist, and the ball is back before you can even whistle. 30-all.
That's a beautiful play.
And really, the speed 40. At which McEnroe thinks, as well as moves and strikes the ball, is bewildering.
So it's break point.
Game, McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 3-2.
So it's 3-2 McEnroe, second set.
Oh! Dean Love. Love.
And McEnroe so close to the net there, couldn't have been more than about 4 feet away. Possibility, of course, of a lob if you've got time to think of it against that fast play.
Love.
At least Lewis got the ball down. The return of service at McEnroe's feet there, who put up a rather easy half volley that should have been a winning lob, I think.
McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 4-2, second set.
So McEnroe has come from 1-2 to lead 4-2 with the break of service, of course, in that run of three games. Really a really big task now. for Lewis. Foot fault court. Foot fault for the second time.
Love 15. Love 30.
Oh, great. Out.
15-30.
This is the chap who made the call.
15-30, first
service. Out, but it was overruled. No player let. Well, it must have been to Malcolm Huntington an obvious mistake. And perhaps that balances the call that Lewis got in his favour.
Five, please.
When he played Kevin Curran. A similar overrule towards the end of the match. 15-30.
Two-four, 30-all,
second set.
Thirty, 40.
Well, that's a miraculous pass, really is.
Game McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 5-2, second set.
McEnroe now serving for the second set, 5-2.
Does Lewis think it was a let?
Again, we have the problem of the lets not being here, but I think these gentlemen may be responsible. Unwittingly, of course, their motor drive cameras make quite a loud noise. 15 love.
Doug. Well,
15-all.
He's human after all. Missed a comparatively easy volley behind the serve.
Thirty, 15. 40-15.
So, two set points for McEnroe for a two sets to love lead.
First service. Game and second set, McEnroe. Change the balls, please. Second set to McEnroe, six games to two.
Well, this is the way that McEnroe made it two sets to love. The tongue sticking from between the teeth as he throws the racket head at the ball, and Lewis at full stretch as McEnroe comes charging in. And the beautiful little drop volley. Such great touch as well as power. The complete player.
White, please.
So those
third set.
Two sets over in 58 minutes.
Love 15. Fifteen all.
Well, Lewis has got to do more, I think, with his first volley behind the, if he gets a chance, that is, behind the service. Good fought for the third time. Quite extraordinary, this man. He expects to play every shot perfectly. No. Yes. It's just out, I think.
40-30.
Called out.
Game, Lewis. First game, third set. Come on. 15, love. Dirty love.
30-15.
And Lewis given the merest chance there. The McEnroe volley not quite as deep as most of his have been so far. And New Zealand has certainly hit that lovely return.
All.
And so far McEnroe hasn't allowed Lewis the luxury of a break point yet. Never got beyond 30 against the service.
One game all, third set.
And they've been on court just an hour and 6 minutes, and they're playing in a temperature of something like 81 out here on the centre court.
Love 15. Love 30. Love 40.
And rather misjudgment there by Lewis. Thought it was going out. Love 40.
McEnroe leads by 2-1, third set, and by 2-0.
McEnroe with his break now in this third set, 2-1.
Love. Love. 40, love.
Well, it seems as though Lewis has got to hit a direct winning return of service if he's to win the rally when McEnroe is serving.
Love.
Well, it seems as though Lewis has got to hit a direct winning return of service if he's to win the rally when McEnroe is serving.
Game, McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 3-1, third set. Quiet, please. Thank you. Love 15. Love 30.
And a change of serving tactics by Lewis there. He didn't follow the service in, hoping that I imagine he would get a bad length ball from McEnroe and go in behind a drive rather than behind the serve. But love 30.
Love 40.
All that came about through a magnificently placed first service, power and accuracy.
Gay McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 4-1, third set.
So it's McEnroe in a truly commanding situation here, 4-1 in the third set, and it's two service breaks he's serving.
First service. Dean Love. 30 love. Game McEnroe. McEnroe leads by 5-1, third set.
So that love game gives McEnroe a chance to go out for his second championship.
Quiet, please, ladies and gentlemen.
He breaks this service.
Thank you. Love, 15. Fifteen all.
The execution and the anticipation of McEnroe there, quite unbelievable. Just out.
30 all.
One, five, 30 all. Third set.
Out. 40-30.
Well served.
Game Lewis. McEnroe leads by 5-2.
At 5-2.
Fifteen, love. First service, corrected call. First service. Fifteen all. Thank you.
30-15.
And that fierce netted service gives McEnroe two championship points.
Quiet, please, ladies and gentlemen. McEnroe wins by 3 sets to love, 6-2, 6-2, 6-2.
And that championship won in 1 hour and 25 minutes. And in your picture there, Alan Mills, the referee, condoling with the runner-up in the championship, a man who has done so marvellously in this championship. So the scene set here for the presentation by the Duke of Kent. But I must say, I said it a little earlier in the commentary, but a man who arrived at his peak absolutely at the right moment. Whereas perhaps Connors was the holder of the title, just failed to hold his peak form that he showed just before the championship started. And in the picture here, one of the truly great players, holder of the singles and the doubles title.
And the traditional lineup of the ball boys and ball girls to form an honour guard for the president of the club, His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent, who will award the trophy. And it's been a treat to watch this man in such tremendous form and under such fine control today. Just acknowledging the shouts from the family and friends, and many, many supporters here. And nice to see the officials there lined up for this presentation ceremony as well, all the linesmen and the umpire. The umpire will be presented to His Royal Highness in the customary manner.
John, it's time for us, I think, again, to say well done to the ball boys and ball girls as they wait for the presentation. And here comes the president of the club, His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent, his family, such great supporters of Wimbledon. With the boys and girls of the London Borough of Merton, New York, Banstead, the boys and girls there, they've done a wonderful job, and from one of the school at Southfields. What a day for them. And so the champion goes forward. Champion goes forward to take the cup from the Duke. And for the second time, he holds it aloft, 1981. His fourth consecutive final. And there is Father McEnroe, as pleased as punch, of course. So the Challenge Cup that was presented to the club by King George V. McEnroe's again, and won for the runner-up, Chris Lewis of New Zealand,
who played one of the greatest matches that Wimbledon has seen for a long time in the semi-final against the South African Kevin Curran. And Virginia Wade, the champion in centenary year 1977, enjoying the moment too. And so Malcolm Huntington receiving thanks, I'm sure, and congratulations from the Duke. And the traditional scene there, and could we have had a more glorious day than this? The two players deep in thought, the New Zealander, but he couldn't have done very much against that marvellous play of McEnroe. So Alan Muirs, the referee, within one match now of concluding his first championship as the referee. A man who represented his country with distinction in the Davis Cup. So McEnroe now does the usual stuff, parading to the crowd and to the photographers. And that cup with all those marvellous names on it, Ball, Gash, Newcomb, Hoad, Laver, Perry, the Musketeers.
And I wonder, Dan, whether young Patrick McEnroe there watching this scene will be out there himself in the future. He got to the semi-final of the juniors this year, and John was following his progress very, very carefully. Great deal of talent, and I'm sure letting the atmosphere here soak in. And of course there's another battery of photographers there on the stands whose view is interrupted by the ones on court, so you have to move across to give them their chance too. And now the fans, reminiscent really of a football occasion, but how nice to see.
Chris Corrigan's with him, the executive secretary of the club.
And now to the fans this side. And I'm sure that's going to win him many, many friends. And I've always thought, Dan, that the players on a tennis court could be more demonstrative to their fans, and how delightful to see John McEnroe doing just that.
And so the warm box stands to the players as they leave for the dressing room, and perhaps not too late to wish the runner-up today good luck in his Davis Cup match. Thank you.